Hey guys, today we're checking out the new LG V60 ThinQ 5G. And these are the newest phones from LG that of course are 5G phones. Now they're using the Qualcomm Snapdragon 865 processor and that X55 modem, which means they're going to support both sub-6 and millimeter wave 5G bands. Now these are flagship phones from LG, so of course you've got pretty high-end specs. You've got 8 GB of RAM, 128 GB of storage, and you've got micro SD card expansion. And LG has traditionally offered all these bells and whistles that a lot of other companies don't really offer with their phones. So you have that micro SD card expansion, and you have the headphone jack. And now that Samsung pulled the headphone jack out of the S20 series, the LG V60 ThinQ is one of the only flagship phones you can get with a headphone jack anymore. And of course, they support that quad DAC. So if you want to get a good headphone listening experience, this is going to be the phone to get. Now LG's got two cameras on the back of this phone. You've got a 64-megapixel main sensor, which bends down to 16 megapixels if you want to get low light, or of course you can use that 64-megapixel mode if you want to. There's also a 13-megapixel wide-angle camera, so there's no telephoto camera in this phone, which is a little disappointing to see, but there are other options if you want to get that. On the front, you've got a 10-megapixel camera. You've also got a time of flight sensor on the back of this phone, so you should be able to do things like bokeh mode a little more easily than if you were just having a main sensor on the phone. Now the LG V60 ThinQ is using a 6.8-inch OLED display that has an aspect ratio of 20.5:9. Not really sure why they didn't go quite 21:9, but it's very, very close to getting that cinema aspect ratio. So while you're not going to be able to get that full aspect of like a cinema quality movie if you're watching Netflix or something like that, you're getting very close. Now the other thing is, because of that Snapdragon 865 processor, you have support for things like HDR 10+. So you're going to be able to get a much more wide spectrum of colors that actually show up on that OLED display. So something else pretty cool about these phones is they're employing 5,000 milliamp hour batteries. Now Samsung Galaxy S20 Ultra is also using a 5,000 milliamp hour battery, but it's got a slightly bigger display, which means it's probably going to use a little bit more power. Now LG's also included Quick Charge 4 in this device, so you'll be able to top it off a little bit quicker than a lot of other devices. As far as software goes, these phones are using Android 10, and there's a couple new interesting features being used in them as well. One of these new features is called Voice Bokeh, and effectively, the phones are looking for voices while you're taking video, and it isolates sound around it. So it uses that AI processing to be able to find voices and make sure your videos are a little bit better. Another feature is this time-lapse feature, so you can set up your phone and it can record for up to an hour and create a really short snippet that allows for time lapses and other things like that. And of course, because these are V-series phones, you've also got the dual display. So LG is using pretty much the same dual display as we saw in the V50, but they said that people were really interested in it, so they added to this phone as well. So we don't have pricing or availability for the V60 ThinQ, but LG did hint that it was going to be cheaper than the Samsung Galaxy S20 small, which means it will be less than $999. So we'll let you know when we have a little bit more information on these phones, but until then, stay tuned to AndroidAuthority.com and the YouTube channel because we will have all that info when we get it. So I'll catch you in the next video.